Hello, friends. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Michelle Fondon, and I'm the author of the new book, Chakra Healing for Vibrant Energy, Exploring Your Seven Energy Centers with Mindfulness, Yoga, and Ayurveda. And we're continuing our series on twin flames. Today, we're going to talk about twin flames and sex, believe it or not. So I'm going to say a few lines of a song from the 80s or 90s. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. That's all I can do because copyright laws. So, you know, the channel will not get monetized if I infringe on copyright laws. It's really funny that I'm talking about this topic because when my eldest was about 5 or 6, I was pregnant. No, it was earlier than that. It was a little bit older. So 9 or 10, I was pregnant with my third. And she wanted to know about where do babies come from. And I was like, I really tried hard to have that conversation and I just couldn't have that conversation. So by the time that we actually did get to the conversation, at that time she was just like, no, I don't really want to know. So I was kind of off the hook, but not super comfortable talking about that. Now I've evolved and changed and grown. So now I'm just talking about it to a potential million people or so. Let's talk about twin flames and sex. There we go. And it came to me because I've been getting some comments on my YouTube channel that are saying that twin flames don't necessarily have to have a sexual relationship, or what if twin flames don't have a sexual relationship? So I always say the collective that I do channel, okay, I'm not saying there's right and wrong. I'm saying the collectivity that I personally channel for are twin flame romantic couples. That is the collectivity that I channel for. I mentioned in other videos that I'm heavily Christian based. I was brought up Catholic. I'm a Christian. I have a heavy Bible background. So anything that I am channeling through is coming through that filter, if you will. And also, I always ask my angels and guides and God and Jesus before I come on to the video for you guys is to help me to channel the highest light and love of God, the highest truth, the highest light and love. That's always my intention. My intention is always to bring this to the highest heights absolutely possible. I personally believe, and this is what I channel, is that sex is an extremely important part of the twin flame connection. I mean, it is right up there at the top. And it's not because of some fantasy. It's not because of some crazy, you know, obsession with sex and sexuality. It has nothing to do with that. We have to look at sex as a simply a transfer of energy and information. And I've talked about this in other videos about how twin flames are transferring energy and information to each other to help heal the wounds inside of themselves, and also to help heal the collectivity, and also to help heal the world. So this is not just about the couple. This is not just about individual pleasure, if you will. Now, for those twin flame couples that are evolved and matured in their growth, they will say the exact same thing. They, hands down, the mature twin flame couples who have evolved and grown into higher states of consciousness will say the exact same thing. So this is nothing new. It's not like I'm just making this up and pulling it out of a hat. This is not something new. As it's being an exchange of energy information, it's extremely important. It's an important part of the twin flame journey in this romantic connection is the sexuality in the connection. A lot of times twin flames are actually activated through sexual activity with each other. So when they have sex for the first time, that is when the activation is happening. That is when they actually recognize that you are my twin flame. That's when they recognize it. A lot of times the experience is like out of this world, meaning like it's just nothing that you've ever experienced before. You may have experienced pleasure before, but it's not at all the same caliber of pleasure. It's just this surreal experience. For those of you that have had this experience, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So it's not anything new. However, if you haven't yet had the experience, when you do have the experience, you'll know what I'm speaking of. You'll know what I'm talking about. That it doesn't have to do with the mechanics of it. It has to do with the spirituality of it. So if we get more into philosophies that are linked to yoga, and some people talk about Kundalini awakening, and I talk a lot about this in my book, Chakra Healing for Vibrant Energy. So if you are not familiar with the chakras and the Kundalini Awakening, I would say go directly to that book. So pick up a copy of that book on Amazon, Barnes & Noble. Just pick up a copy where you can, because I really speak a lot about the activation of the chakras and the Kundalini Awakening. Now this does, it's not related to twin flames. However, the Kundalini Awakening is the same whether you're in a twin flame relationship or not. It's just that activation. And within the activation of the Kundalini Awakening, you're also aligning the chakras, and you're aligning that yin yang energy that I was talking about in previous videos, and that I talk about in the twin flame connection. It's that masculine feminine energy, the yin yang energy, and the dynamic that helps to bring you guys into reunion. So I'm starting to use that term when I speak of the union that comes after the separation, is that reunion. The balance of energies is what is going to help you guys come into that reunion. The complementary energies of, if you're the divine feminine, staying in your divine feminine energy. If your divine masculine is in the masculine energy, staying in that divine masculine energy, so that you guys can come together as a perfect match, as a perfect pair. So the sexual relationship that you have with your twin is extremely important to help balance out these energies. So you realize that the mechanics of it are different than all of the other things that are actually happening in this sexual relationship. So another thing about twin flames, and I've said this in previous videos, is the shattering of paradigms. This is an extremely important one. So twin flames are here to actually shatter paradigms, all sorts of paradigms. We have these preconceived notions in society, in our upbringing, according to human-made rules, according to interpretations of religions, for example. And we have all these preconceived notions of how things should be and how we are supposed to act. And sex is one of those things that, because of the Puritan background, especially in the Western world, that we have grown up around, and this is just not in this generation, we're talking about many previous generations as well, but we've grown up around the notion that sex is bad, sex is dirty, sex is shameful, it's something that must not be talked about, it's lustful, it's horrible, so that creates a suppression of energy. When you create that suppression of energy, it becomes a buildup of energy. And when it does, it's usually like this negative energy that's building up because of the suppression, and it comes out in a lot of unhealthful ways. And when you are living under this type of suppression, whether it is societal, religious, family-based, or personal-based, it's just an unhealthy energy that you're accumulating. So whether it's because you are in a marriage and you're remaining faithful to your partner, or it's you were brought up in a certain religious doctrine, and that religious doctrine said that sex was just for procreation, or if it's just your parental upbringing, that your parents just emphasized that it was a dirty act, or it was shameful, it wasn't good. Everyone has a different background when it comes to sex and sexual relationships. So what the twin flame connection is designed to do, among other things, but is to shatter those paradigms, is to break those paradigms, is to break through. And what I said in my book, so I'm writing my book on twin flames, as many of you know, and I'm nearing almost finishing close to halfway. So I'm almost to the halfway point, not quite there yet, but almost. And one of the things that I say about sexuality and twin flames is the breaking of these paradigms, is breaking apart these paradigms. And when it comes to God, God created you to be a sexual being, right? God knew what he was doing. So by you saying that I am not a sexual being, or sex can't be a part of this twin flame journey because it's too spiritual, it's too much of a spiritual journey, or I could be with someone who is my twin flame but not have a sexual relationship. What you're saying is that God made a mistake here. That's what you're saying. You're saying, like, God made a mistake. Clearly, God didn't know what he was doing. And God knew exactly what he was doing when he created us to be sexual beings. And so when you embrace the wholeness of who you are, and you really fully embrace that wholeness of who you are, you're embracing every single piece of you. You're embracing every single part of you. That's what yoga means. Yoga means union. And I've been a yoga teacher for the past 11 years. So what I teach and preach is that it's the integrative union, first of yourself. So it's when you integrate your mind, body, soul, spirit, and everything that is all-inclusive in who you are, your thoughts, your words, your deeds, your actions, your wounds, your past, your present, your future. You're embracing everything of who you are, and that's the yoga, that's the union. But as it extends outward, you're becoming to accept everything that is in the universe and the laws of the universe. And part of the laws of the universe is that God created us to be sexual beings. So, and God gave us that as a gift, and he gave us that as a gift to not abuse of it, not be careless and not be promiscuous, if you will, but in the sense of, like, be responsible with that gift. And honestly, it goes for anything that God gives you as a gift. He gives you this body to take care of. And so if you overeat, if you under-exercise, if you eat the wrong foods, if you take drugs and alcohol, like, you are not doing your duty to God as far as taking care of this temple that he gave you. So it goes hand in hand. We can't just sever or separate one part of who we are and embrace the rest of it. It's just not healthy. So when you look at it from that perspective, that sex with your twin is an exchange of energy and information, and that makes it so much more accepting, if you will. Now, there is a pleasure aspect of it. That's what you guys need to remember, is that there's nothing wrong with having a pleasurable aspect of celebrating life and who you are and celebrating the connection and celebrating this beautiful, wonderful, magical connection with your twin, which is like something so incredible and amazing. And it makes me emotional even to think about it, because the connection that I have with my twin is just so incredibly beautiful and amazing and magical and different than any other connection that I've ever had. And it's just something to be celebrated, right? It's not something to be ashamed of. It's something to be so celebrated and have gratitude for that, and have this sense of gratitude and thanking God that he gave you this sense of pleasure, this sense of being able to receive that pleasure. Another thing that is not often talked about, and I'm not going to go into too much detail about this, is telepathic sex between twins. It is absolutely real. It's something that I personally did not think was real, but is absolutely real. It's something very surreal, but it is real, 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 real. So, for those of you that have not yet had this telepathic experience with your twin, it is something that you can connect with your twin in the fifth dimension or in this more spiritual realm, and you come together with this experience. Now, a lot of times the experience comes to you when you're not necessarily expecting it. And sometimes it can happen within the dream realm as well. And sometimes often does happen in the dream realm. A lot of times it'll happen in the waking state. So when you're in the waking state of consciousness, the waking state of being, you can have this telepathic sexual experience with your twin and just experience it fully. Now, I can't tell you what the experience will be for you. Everybody has a different experience, right? So I'm not going to share my experience, but I can only tell you that it's something that you probably have never experienced prior to this. It's something, like I said, surreal, meaning like it doesn't feel like it's possible to be real, but it is real. There are some other byproducts of that that are very interesting. Again, I don't feel super comfortable talking about them online. I will include them in my book, because including them in a book, like, you know, someone who's going to go out and actually purchase the book is going to be a little bit different than someone accidentally clicking on a YouTube video. So yeah, that is totally real. It's real. Just think about that as you're thinking about your perspective today, when you're thinking about the perspective of a twin flame relationship. Now, some of you might be thinking, well, I feel my twin flame is like a best friend, or I feel like a twin flame is someone who's the same gender as me, same sex, but I am not gay or lesbian. So then a sexual encounter is not possible in my eyes. It's just nothing for me. Or being like a relative, like a cousin or something like that, where clearly it's just not a possibility. So I would say that, and I've said this in other videos as well, that for me, a twin flame is the wholeness. It's the wholeness of everything. So it's all inclusive, and there's nothing that is excluded from a twin flame relationship. So your split soul with your twin is going to include all the flavors of life, all the emotions of life, all the wholeness of life, all the wholeness of everything that you could possibly experience. It's going to be all contained within this container, which is your relationship with your twin. It's going to be all inclusive, if you will, like going to an all-inclusive resort. It's going to be all inclusive, so that if you have relationships that are not all inclusive, it's not a twin flame connection. It might be a really, really strong soulmate connection. It might be a really, really strong karmic connection, but it's not a twin flame connection. And I'm correcting myself from something that I actually said in a really early video, because in a really early video, I had read a book that was published a long time ago. This book was probably published like 30 years ago, perhaps, about twin flames. And the person did mention being in a twin flame relationship with someone with such an, I mean, this is just an example of someone with such a great age difference, like 50 years age difference, that like a sexual relationship just wasn't on the table, wasn't in the cards, wasn't possible. But I would say that that relationship likely must have been a very strong soulmate relationship, because there are relationships that mimic twin flame relationships that are called false twins. And a lot of times these false twin relationships are a preparatory phase. It's like taking the SAT prep course in order to take the SAT. So it's like a prep course to get you prepared and ready for what's to come in a twin flame connection. So I personally believe, and this is what I channel, and this is what I teach and preach, and this is the information that I receive from God and the angels, is that the twin flame connection is the whole bowl, is the whole container. It's the whole container of life, containing every single flavor of life, every single experience of life as is possible. And if you cannot say that there is wholeness on every single level with that relationship, then it's not a twin flame connection. So that's really how you can tell the difference. But sexuality, sex with your twin, is definitely a part of this. It's really essentially for health and healing and wholeness, breaking, shattering paradigms. Of course, connection to your twin, love and connection and affection is so important in every relationship, but especially in romantic partnerships, right? You want that connection, you want that affection, you want that love. It's really necessary. So there you go. There's our little sex talk. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for subscribing to my channel below. Share this video with other twin flames. And thank you so much for supporting this channel and my work and what I do by buying a book or two or three, and supporting me on Patreon, www.patreon.com/MichelleSFondon. And I will see you in the next video.